This is just for some people who, one person in particular, so hello, hello, who is not feeling comfortable coming into the club and is really missing taking class with us. So I'm going to run through one piece of our choreography facing this way on my step real quickly, and then we will get ourselves warmed up, and I'll turn back to facing. So just a preview for what's coming for those of you at home. It's here, 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 stand up, step back, lunge, 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 and up, and then single, single, double, and then down, down, up, off the back, and a jack. Then the left foot on. Three, two, one, step up, step back. Three, two, one, up we go, single, single, then your double, this leg down, up, off the back, and jack. And you'll have the option, we'll break all that down. On your up, up, down, down, you'll have the option to hop on top only if you want it. So that's the preview. I'm going to turn myself back. This is for, mostly for the people who are watching the supporting later. But that might have been helpful to some of you as well. All right, let's do this. Who's ready? Sinead's ready, right? March it out. I'm going to come around. Still that rocking horse. start rotating that rib cage right above the hips. Four more. Three. Two. One short cross. Walk it front. One short cross. Walk it front. Hold your short cross. Now you can keep the short cross and watch where we're headed next. It's a straddle. So we step up like we're going into the short cross, but then we head right back down. So we're up, up, down, down. Again. Two more. One more. Now short cross. Three times. Two more. One more. Walk it to the front. Hold your short cross. Hold it. Two more. Take it to that straddle. Up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. Two more times. Short cross for three. One more. Walk it to the front. Knees corner, corner. Now listen. One short cross. Walk it to the front. Short cross. Walk it to the front. This is going to work the whole time, cross and walk. If you want, you can change it to a chasse. If that's too much, it can be a little confusing to change direction. If you're new, stick with the march. Again, a little wider, a little lower. One more. Heel tap right here. Woo! Keep your heel tap. Thank you. Little faster, so we're down, down, drive, let's go. Woo! Now if you want That concrete box can be in your imagination, but we've all got one. There is something you wish you could break out of today. Maybe it's COVID, I don't know. But it's something, so if you're gonna break out, really mean it. Let's go. Down. Break out. Bam. Concrete pieces flying. Pow. Ha. Single, single. Matter because we're going to be on Working challenge. And if you don't like it, you go back to the tap. So on this one, it is the leg that's on the bench you want to be focused on. Knee is still over that ankle. And we're lowering these muscles. So, high impact. If you want it, squat hop. But we are landing with cat-like feet. Silent, gentle. If that gets me too much, it's back here or here. Woo!
Yeah. add resistance, so do the arms. So the shoulder blades while working. Imaginary tennis ball, step right between them. Squeeze them together so tight the air punches out of the tennis ball. Core braced. Roll and set at the top. Woo! Set your weights down. Onto your mat.
Don't let them touch the floor. And then drive into those hands. Feel that strength in that upper body. that push-up. Keep it going. If this starts to be too much, be done. Remember, arms are in close. Feel a little stretch against the ribs. Our poor little triceps get neglected a lot. We do everything up here with the biceps. Triceps, we gotta give them that little head start. Tailbone again, round all the way up through the back. Relax head and neck. Really round out that upper back, hollowing the chest. And back to neutral. Go ahead and spin it around, backside. Lay it back one vertebrae at a time. And then bring your knees into the chest. Hug them in nice and close. Feel that stretch in the low back and the glutes. Draw a great big circle in the air with those toes. And then reverse the chest. Well done, you guys. Woo. Just give a little mental thank you to your body right now. Carrying you through all of that. We finished. Point and flex the feet. Exaggerate the point so that you feel that stretch across the top of the foot, the ankle, and the shin. And breathe. Go ahead and take your left knee over your left hip. Right ankle can come across. Figure four stretch, so you reach around that left thigh and hug it in. If you feel like you can take a little more stretch in that hip today, instead of the ankle, we're going to take the knee across that left quadricep. Slide our hands down the shins as far as we can get towards those ankles. Grab on like you're pulling a shoelace. And bring those legs down towards the floor. It's a lot more intense on that hip, so if it's too much, go back to that figure four. And release. Switch sides. Right knee over right hip. Left ankle comes across for figure four. Reach around that thigh and hug that right leg into the chest. Feel the stretch. If you feel like you can take a little more today, slide the knee all the way over that quad. And slide down the shins towards the ankles. They don't have to get all the way there. And then bring those legs down and into the chest. Great big breath in, fill those lungs. And release, tuck the knees into the chest again. We're going to extend the right leg long onto the floor. Flex that foot. Right hand goes up in the air, outside of that left thigh. Left arm goes long on the floor, and then take that left leg across the body. Spinal twist along the forehip stretch. A lot of up and down on that step.
exhale, bring that knee back up over the hip. Extend that leg out nice and long. Flex that left foot. Bring the right knee in. Left arm goes up. Outside of that thigh, bring the leg across the body. Nice and slow. You might feel some little popping back there in your spine. Just slowly, slowly. Right arm can come straight out, or if you're having a hard time keeping that
even
right shoulder blade on the floor.
On.
Football field goal arm, so bend 90 degrees at the elbow, palm up.
Fall it out.
Great big breath in, and as you exhale, press that knee back up over that hip. We keep that
step
knee there, bring the other leg
time,
in. Slide your hands up those legs and grab on just around your ankle area. And then we're going to gently press those knees down and out to the side towards your armpits. Tailbone is down on the floor, so we're not rounding through that core. Tailbone down, and then just gentle pressure, flex the feet. Feel the groin open up, a little more hip opening.
Seems like
the inner thigh and groin getting some stretch here too. And release. Bring those knees together, core tight, roll it up to a seated position. Come all the way forward on the balls of the feet, press the heels back.
You do not know your
and then slowly round it up one vertebrae at a time. Use your body as support.
So don't
recording thing, so I apologize for that. Arms up. Press those palms to the ceiling. Reach, lengthen. Take your thumb between your shoulder blades. Press back. And then take that leg of the same arm you're stretching back behind you up on the ball of the foot. Tilt your pelvis and lower that knee until you feel some stretch in that quadricep. Knee should be over the ankle on the front leg. And then release. Other arm up. Thumb between the shoulder blade, press back, take that back leg behind you up on the ball of the foot, lower that groin towards the floor, knee right over the ankle on that front leg if you need to take it out further to you, just press that hip forward if you want to feel some stretch through this quadricep and hip flexor here, and release, step those feet together, great big inhale, and exhale, nice job you guys, well done.